Okay, everybody, so in this video, this is more or less for the bass drummers. We're going to talk about bass drum notation, okay? The magic number for drum line, for a number of bass drums, is 5. In our course, in our school, we have 5 bass drums. They go from smallest to largest, so we have 5. We've got a 16-inch bass drum, 18-inch bass drum, a 20-inch bass drum, a 22-inch bass drum, and a 26-inch bass drum. And the numbers go from 1 all the way to 5. So if you play bass 5, you'd be playing the 26-inch bass drum. If you play bass 3, you'd be playing the 20-inch bass drum. Okay? Now, depending on the music that you play, you need to know where your drum that you play is located on the staff and when all the bass drums play together. So just like in the tenor video, if you go watch the tenor video, the highest drum is on top. So in our case, the highest bass drum is going to be on top of the staff here. And again, the spaces on the staff are numbered 1 to 4 from bottom to top. Okay? So above space 4, above the 5th line, that's where bass drum 1 is going to be. Okay? And then you can fill in the rest as you go down. There's a bass drum in all of the spaces. Okay? So I already told you that this bass drum was bass drum number 1. Here. Right? The 4th space from the bottom is going to be bass drum number 2. The 3rd space from the bottom is going to be bass drum number 3. The 2nd space from the bottom is going to be bass drum number 4. And the 5th space from the bottom, or the 1st space from the bottom, is going to be bass drum number 5. Okay, so the lower the drum, the bigger the drum, the lower on the staff is, okay? Bass drummers also play notes all together. Those notes are written on the 3rd line, line number 3. There's 5 lines. Numbered 1 to 5 from bottom to top. The ones that are played all together are written on line 3. That's all the bass drums are going to play that note together on that line. Okay? The other notation that you need to be familiar with if you play bass drum would be an X on top here. Like where bass drum number 1 would be, there would be an X. On your drum, you have a rim. That would be where all the bass drummers would hit the rims of their drums. Okay? So you need to know where your drum is written, where the other drums are written. Bass drum 1, bass drum 2, bass drum 3, bass drum 4, bass drum 5. All in the spaces. If all the bass drums are playing one note, it's on line number 3. And if you need to play a rim click with all the bass drums together, that would be on the top line, exactly where bass drum number 1 would be. Okay? Now, that's for 5 bass drums. Let's say, for instance, in class, we only had 4 bass drums. Okay? And we got rid of bass drum number 1. All right? Some drum lines have 4 bass drums. That's fine. Everything would stay the same, except you just wouldn't use the top line. So this would turn into bass drum number 1, and this would turn into 2, 3, and 4. And then this would turn into 1, 2, 3, and 4. This would still be all of the bass drums, and this would still be your rim. Okay? So we just wouldn't use this top line here. We just wouldn't use it if there was only 4 bass drums. Okay? So every bass drum player needs to know where their drum is located on the staff so that we can play 5 bass drum parts and 4 bass drum parts if people are absent. Okay? Good job.